Hello everyone, my name is Efthymios Tzinis, and today I'm going to present to you our work, Separate But Together, Unsupervised Federated Learning for Speech Enhancement from non-IID Data. This is a joint work with Jonah and Zhepei, my lab mates, and my advisor, Smaragdis. So we're going to talk in this work about the new speech enhancement. Right now, we have time-domain audio source separation, which provides state-of-the-art results using time-domain models. And of course, speech enhancement is a specific instance of this problem, so we use those models there as well. Of course, we need lots of supervised data in order to train these models, but it's impossible to capture any kind of real-world test mixture distribution using such limited supervised data collection setup. This is why we need self-supervised methods in the first. On the other hand, we can't meet the assumption that all of the data are going to be available at once on a single device. So different users might have diverse data, but they might not be willing to share their data with each other or with any kind of server. And this is why we need federated learning. So for the first aspect of the self-supervised speech enhancement, we know that there is the mixture invariant training setup where it can provide a good algorithm for self-supervised audio source separation. And of course, for speech enhancement as well, where we create a mixture of mixtures from two individual mixtures, and we let the model separate a few sources. And we take the loss after assigning these estimated sources back to the initial mixtures. So for the specific case of the speech enhancement, we can create this mixture of mixtures using a noisy mixture, a clean speech plus noise, and one clean noise recordings, whereas the model will have three output slots, one for speech and the other two for the rest of the sources. Of course, there are certain limitations about this approach, which has to do that all of the data would be available on the same device. And here comes the federated learning in order to fill that gap, which is a distributed training framework where users do not need to share data in order to collaboratively train a model. So first, the server owns a global version of this model and distributes it back to each one of those users, as we see here. So then each one of the users are going to perform local updates using their local data, and they're going to send back their updates to the server that where the latter is going to, on its turn, is going to redistribute back the updated model. Of course, we have seen that there are several limitations with such federated learning approaches from works in the literature that they have shown diminishing performance when we have non-IID data across the users when applying harder tasks than detection, such as separation or another estimation task. And the most important one is what happens when you have to train on a local level without having ground truth sources, the ground truth labels in general. So our proposed algorithm, which is called FEDENHANCE in a nutshell, what it does is that it provides such federated learning framework that it can train completely unsupervised, but it can also incorporate supervised nodes, as we can see here on the right. And each one of those nodes performs local updates, gives the updates back to the server, and the server performs the global update and sends back the model after performing federated averaging. So in more detail, we're going to see how the FEDENHANCE works. So first, we begin with a randomly initialized or a pre-trained network that the server has. This is really important. We're going to see why in a little bit. And the model distributes this version of the model to each one of those clients. So each one of those clients has the same model, a speech enhancement model right now. So now we need to update this model and we have to perform local training. So for example, in the case of the unsupervised training, we have a mixture of clean speech, speaker plus some noise, and then a second mixture containing only a noise recording, and you have a separation model with three output slots. And the loss function for this unsupervised node is going to be the regular mixture invariant training loss function. Whereas in the supervised case, we have access to the clean speech, as we see here in the leftmost point of this loss function. So we can use that in order to regress over it. And we can use regular permutation variant training for the rest of the two sources in the mixture. So we see here that after we perform those local updates on each one of the local devices, we can perform asynchronous model updates by sending back our model weights to the server. And of course, there are going to be users that they haven't, they couldn't update their model or send it back to the server by that time. So the server is responsible for performing the model updates. So it's going to aggregate those updates by a simple averaging scheme. So it's going to aggregate those models for the from all that it got from all of the nodes that contributed to this communication round, and it's going to get the new model that is going to distribute it back to each one of the clients again in order to perform the new communication round. And of course, this includes nodes which did not participate in the previous communication round. For the local model training, we could use any kind of separation model that we'd like, but in order to remain, to respect realistic hardware requirements in terms of several devices that users have, we chose the pseudo-MRF model architecture, which performs comparable to state-of-the-art models, using less parameters, being more lightweight in terms of memory requirements, and being really fast. And on top of the pseudo-MRF architecture, we use a mixture consistency projection layer. And the loss function in terms of the signal level loss function with our estimated source and the target is going to be the negative scale invariant signal to distortion ratio. We also introduce a new dataset called LibreFSD50K, which is the conglomeration of the Libre speech for the speech samples and the FSD50K with a diverse set of sound of noise sources. And we can see here that we get some kind of realistic input SNR distributions for one or two, when one or two noise sources are present. And the most important aspect of this data set is that we have multiple speaker IDs that we can distribute to the clients. So each client does not have any overlap in terms of the ID and perform completely non-IID training. You can find the data generation recipe online and you can use it for your own experiment. We're gonna show three different experiments. The first one is to show that we can actually perform unsupervised federated speech enhancement from scratch, where we split the speaker IDs equal to the number of clients, and we randomly assign the noise sources to those clients. So each its local update is gonna have one training epoch for each client before they communicate their updates. And we assume also that only 25% of the clients are available at each communication round. The second experiment is gonna be for transfer learning, where the initial speech enhancement model is not gonna be a random seed, but is gonna be a pre-trained model using the WAM dataset, and where we perform pre-training on a smaller set of noise sources, so it has less diversity than our LibreFSD50K. And the last one is to show that we can effectively combine supervised and unsupervised clients and different loss functions under the same federated learning setup. So we see here that with solid lines, we have the convergence as we increase the number of communication rounds, where Each one of the solid lines represents the FEDENHANCE at different with different number of clients, as we see here. And we can see that we can scale pretty good in terms of the number of clients, and we can effectively obtain a better performance as we scale and the problem becomes way, way harder. And all of that is learning under a completely unsupervised and a completely federated manner with non-IID data distribution in terms of our mixtures. So now we can measure how well we perform compared to the upper bound of the IID training setup, which is the dashed black line on top, which is effectively performing mixture invariant training when we assume that we have all of the data available on a single device. And of course, if we compare each one of those FEDENHANCE setups, federated learning setups, with the isolated training, where we have the same amount of data at each local node, we see that, for example, for the case of 256 clients, the isolated training completely fails, whereas when we collaboratively train our model, we can obtain a significant improvement over the input mixture without having a single ground truth speaker waveform and starting completely from scratch. We notice that exactly the same applies when we have two noise sources at our evaluation mixtures instead of one. So we see the same convergence speed and the same behavior in terms of the non-IID and IID training. And also for the second experiment, we see that our model can be significantly improved in terms of its convergence speed, even when pre-training on a smaller data set such as one. So we see, for example, here for the case of the 256, which 256 from scratch, which is the solid yellow line. After 1,000 communication rounds, we are pretty much at the same level as the one that we were when just performing the pre-training and a single communication round, after a single communication round and pre-training over here. So we see that we can develop more efficient federated learning algorithms when we employ and we exploit this kind of transfer learning setups. Also, for our last experiment, we see that FEDENHANCE can effectively combine different loss functions. We fix the number of clients to 64, and we sweep the number of supervised nodes. So we see here that by just adding 25% of the nodes to be supervised, we can boost our performance from the completely unsupervised setting. And we can see the trend from the completely unsupervised to the fully supervised setup, where we can increase the performance and our algorithm is able to perform, to scale and perform better when having supervised information available. So in order to conclude, we have proposed FEDENHANCE, which is the first federated learning system for speech enhancement, but more generally, is the first system that performs completely unsupervised training with good performance under realistic, noisy, and non-IID settings, as we have shown in our experimental setup. And more importantly, with comparable performance to single device IID training, where all of the data are available at the same time. And finally, FEDENHANCE has shown significant effectiveness in terms of combining different loss functions, such as supervised and unsupervised loss function, with the regular permutation invariant training and mixture invariant training. We have also introduced a new dataset that can be used for federated learning, speech enhancement, and other speech enhancement tasks. And also in the future, we aim to extend our algorithm in order to cover multiple other settings, such as multimodal settings, and also remove the assumptions about having access to in-domain noise samples when performing the mixture invariant training. So I would like to thank you very much for watching this video. and attending the talk. You can find the code online as well as the dataset, and I would be more than happy to answer your questions in the Q&A session. Thanks.